Today my talk is the best way to have this understanding to Quran. The best way it's to learn Arabic language.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين عم يتساءلون عن النبأ العظيم الذي هم فيه مختلفون كلا سيعلمون ثم كلا سيعلمون ألم نجعل الأرض مهادا والجبال أوتادا وخلقناكم أزواجا وجعلنا نومكم سباتا وجعلنا الليل لباسا وجعلنا النهار معاشا وبنينا فوقكم سبعا شدادا وجعلنا سراجا وهاجا وأنزلنا من المعصرات ماء ثجاجا لنخرج به حبا ونباتا وجنات ألفافا إن يوم الفصل كان ميقاتا يوم ينفخ في الصور فتأتون أفواجا وفتحت السماء فكانت أبوابا وسيرت الجبال فكانت سرابا إن جهنم كانت مرصادا طاغين مآبا لابثين فيها أحقابا لا يذوقون فيها بردا ولا شرابا إلا حميما وغساقا جزاء وفاقا إنهم كانوا لا يرجون حسابا وكذبوا بآياتنا كذابا وكل شيء أحصيناه كتابا فذوقوا فلن نزيدكم إلا عذابا إن للمتقين مفازا إن للمتقين مفازا حدائق وأعنابا وكواعب أترابا وكأسا دهاقا لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا كذابا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما الرحمن لا يملكون منه خطابا يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صوابا ذلك اليوم الحق ذلك اليوم الحق ذلك اليوم الحق فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه مآبا ذلك اليوم الحق فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه مآبا إنا أنذرناكم عذابا قريبا يوم ينظر المرء ما قدمت يداه ويقول الكافر يا ليتني كنت ترابا والنازعات غرقا والناشطات نشطا والسابحات سبحا فالسابقات سبقا فالمدبرات أمرا يوم ترجف الراجفة تتبعها الرادفة قلوب يومئذ واجفة أبصارها خاشعة يقولون أئنا لمردودون في الحافرة أئذا كنا عظاما نخرة قالوا تلك إذا كرة خاسرة فإنما هي زجرة واحدة فإذا هم بالساهرة هل أتاك حديث موسى إذ ناداه ربه بالوادي المقدس طوى اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقل هل لك إلى أن تزكى وأهديك إلى ربك فتخشى فأراه الآية الكبرى فكذب وعصى ثم أدبر يسعى فحشر فنادى فقال أنا ربكم الأعلى فأخذه الله نكال الآخرة والأولى إن في ذلك لعبرة لمن يخشى إن في ذلك لعبرة لمن يخشى أأنتم أشد خلقا أم السماء بناها رفع سمكها فسواها وأغطش ليلها وأخرج ضحاها والأرض بعد ذلك دحاها أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها والجبال أرساها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم فإذا جاءت الطامة الكبرى يوم يتذكر الإنسان ما سعى يوم يتذكر الإنسان ما سعى وبرزت الجحيم لمن يرى فأما من طغى وآثر الحياة الدنيا فإن الجحيم هي المأوى وأما من خاف مقام ربه وأما من خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس عن الهوى فإن الجنة هي المأوى يسألونك عن الساعة أيان مرساها فيما أنت من ذكراها إلى ربك منتهاها إنما أنت منذر من يخشاها كأنهم يوم يرونها لم يلبثوا إلا عشية أو ضحاها. أو ضحاها.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمدا عبده ورسوله، خيرته من خلقه وخليله. اللهم صل وسلم عليه أفضل ما صليت وسلمت على أحد من العالمين. الحمد لله that Allah gave us also chance, another chance to live another day, and give us health to worship Him, give us permission to mention His name. May Allah تبارك وتعالى give us حسن الخاتمة and make the last word in our life لا إله إلا الله. So yesterday, inshallah, I try to make a talk, inshallah, short in weekdays, inshallah. Yesterday we talked about the importance of your intention when you recite Quran. When you recite Quran as a guidance, everything will change. You will read slowly. You will pause a lot. You will ask a lot of questions because you need guidance. Every story you come across, you reflect and try to derive lessons for your modern life. For example, the first story in Quran, قصة آدم, you will ask yourself, what does that mean for me? Which lesson I can derive from this story in my modern life? And so on. So a lot of questions will come to your mind because you want guidance. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, for this guidance, He named just one surah in Quran. Among 114 surahs, there's only one surah. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam named this surah with one of the names of the Quran. Suratul Furqan. When Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala choose one surah to have the name of Quran, He choose Al-Furqan, not even Al-Quran. Al-Furqan is clear distinguish between Haqq and Batil, between truth and falsehood. That clear distinction is one of the main purpose of reading Quran. When you read as a guidance, Haqq will be very clear to you and Batil will be very clear to you. Today my talk is the best way to have this understanding to Quran. The best way, it's to learn Arabic language. You may look at me and say, but how? This is difficult. I want to emphasize this topic today because we want to change something in this ummah. We want to deliver a message for our generation. Those people who have children and they want to teach their children English, French, Spanish, many languages, so they can involve in this dunya, teach your children Arabic. Arabic is not a language of race, specific race. Arabic is a language of the Holy Book. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala said in Surah Ibrahim, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ. Every prophet Allah sent, He sent him with the same language to his nation. So he can deliver a message in proper way. Okay, we know that every single messenger, Allah sent him in a specific nation, except our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. Allah has sent him to all mankind, but mankind have different languages. So which language Allah will choose for the last prophet to convey the message to all humanity? Allah said, نزل به الروح الأمين على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين بلسان عربي مبين. Allah has chosen Arabic language to be the international language to convey the message. It means there is some features in this language unique. That's why it can convey this message. Very precise. Arabic language can even convey the emotions. can express the situation in very concise words. For example, in Surah Yusuf, if you know Arabic very well and you come across this ayah, Yusuf say to his brother after many years, more than 20 years, أَوَى إِلَيْهِ أَخَاهُ قَالَ إِنِّي أَنَا أَخُوكَ. If you know Arabic very well, you'll pause here. Why Allah used this expression, إِنِّي أَنَا أَخُوكَ? That's a lot of words in Arabic. He can say إِنِّي أَخُوكَ and that's it. Or أَنَا أَخُوكَ. إني أخوك, indeed, I'm your brother. Or أنا أخوك, I'm your brother. But he said, indeed, me, I am your brother. Which is very strange expression. And when this very strange expression, it means there's something behind it. Because this expression just to convey the message, the emotion of Yusuf and his brother, after 20 years, I am the prime minister of Egypt who stand in front of you is your own brother. Very concise. From the beginning of Islam till the 12th centuries, Arabic was dominant in all Muslim countries. Anyone convert to Islam, immediately the first job, the first mission for him is to learn Arabic. All our history, immediately, regardless his race or nation, why he want to understand Arabic. That's why we have some great scholars in our history. They are from different races, and they know Arabic more than the all Arab people nowadays. Even the amazing thing is, the most important book in Arabic grammar, Al-Kitab, the author of this book is Sibawi. He's Farsi. Can you imagine the main book in Arabic grammar in our history? His author is Farsi. Because that time, Arabic is not a language of race. It's a language of religion. So everyone start to learn Arabic. Bukhari is from Uzbekistan. He's not Arab, but he know Arabic more than me and you. Tirmidhi, An-Nasa'i, Ibn Majah, Abu Hanifa, one of the greatest scholar in Madahib Arba'a, he's not Arab. So what happened then? Even the biggest Arabic dictionary, Tajul Arus fi Sharh al-Qamus, the biggest Arabic dictionary, the author is from India. Al-Zabidi is not Yemen. He just lived in Yemen most of his life. So they said Zabid because of the city of Zabid. But is he originally from India? The biggest Arabic dictionary. What happened with Muslim world then? Why they don't want to learn Arabic now? Even in the time of where the languages become very easy, many apps in your phone, you can learn any language. But we don't have this passion to learn Arabic. 2 centuries ago, a big shift happened in Muslim world. Many Muslim countries, they used to written their own languages in Arabic letter, just out of love of the Quran. Many of African languages used to written in Arabic letters. 2 centuries ago, 1.5 centuries, 1 century ago, when they conquered these countries, the first thing they did, they want to cut their relationship between Quran, so they start to force these countries to change the letters to Latin letters. They know what they do. Because when you cut the people from Quran, they can't understand it except from translations. This is a big problem. And now we still have 1/6 main languages in Africa. They have more than 50% Arabic words or roots. Look at Swahili, at Somali, at many main languages had many Arabic words. And we still have some Arabic or some languages, Muslim languages, still written in Arabic letters. Kurdish, Malayo, Pashto, Urdu, Punjabi, Kashmiri, all this still. Turkish before 1988, also in Arabic. Why they write in Arabic? They want to have this connection with Quran, because it's very, very important. It's very sad that when you ask many Arab children now, what's the meaning of As-Samad, they don't know. I'm serious. Go and ask any child who is Arabic, he born from Arab country, they don't know the meaning of As-Samad. So the best way to understand Quran is to learn Arabic. Because when you learn Arabic, you will feel, you will taste the words of Quran. Quran is not just about concepts and meaning. Even how Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala chose this language, if you know Arabic very well, you just will taste it. Sometimes you can't express the feeling come to your mind, wallahi, if you know Arabic. So if we want to build a good connection, at least, this is message for every parent or everyone here who want to get married. Please keep in your mind to set this goal. I want to teach my children Arabic. And the intention of that, just to make that connection with Quran. If we do that, we did a great job for this next generation. Because then they have built this connection with Quran. And it's very, very important. So I encourage every parent here who has a small child, don't let your child to look at or watch a cartoon in English language, especially in very young age, 3 years old, 4 years old, is very critical age. He can learn Arabic in this age just by watching cartoon in Arabic language, just by that. And we have many examples for this. Arabic Fusha. I have a daughter. She used to watch the cartoon from very young age in Arabic Fusha. She used to talk in Arabic, 4 years old, fluent Fusha, because just she imitate the cartoon. And we have many good cartoons now about the life of the Prophet ﷺ, the stories in Quran, many things. We just want to control, have this mission. We are in trouble because about this connection, lack of connection with Quran. So this is a message for every parent, every teacher, every leader. We should do something for next generation. Teach them Arabic. They will taste this Quran. They will look at the sweetness of Quran. They will build a good connection with Quran. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make us among Ahlul Quran. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make our children pious. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala put the sweetness of Iman in our hearts. Wallahu a'lam wa sallallahu ala abdi rasuli Sayyidina Muhammad.